Okay, we took it there.
Yo, that's not funny, real talk.
That was like the most.
Yo, don't ever slap me like that again, alright?
Excuse me?
I always start with a clap.
Alright, let's go. Got it. What the fuck is this? Why are you shooting at me? That shit made me so mad. What the fuck? Don't do that. Don't put your hands in my face.
What is going on? Welcome to today's video. We got two cameras going because George's got a camera. We're doing a Q&A in this video. We're answering all things fitness, non-fitness, whatever. We're just going to go off the rip, go through questions that you guys asked us on Instagram. Made a post yesterday, got my red Solo cup, pure vodka, it's water. And let's just get into it. So the first question, George is going to answer when I ask, and then I'll answer after, and then vice versa. What does success look like to you, George?
Oh, damn, right off the bat with the big boy question.
I'm just going.
I didn't get a chance to warm up.
Wow. what does success mean to me? What was the question?
What's going to say in your gravestone? First question.
What is it?
It's a little dark, I'm sorry. The question is, what does success look like to you?
Shit, man. Honestly, to keep it simple. Yeah, I think it's freedom of time. Freedom of location, and man, just unconditional relationships, I kind of want to say.
Unconditional relationships?
Yeah, unconditional relationships.
I like that. Success to me, I think success to me is what you said on freedom, having the ability to do what you want, essentially when you want to do it.
Absolutely.
And success is keeping family at the center. And this is something that throughout my 20s I've come back to and realized that's really all that matters at the end of the day.
Absolutely.
So success is when I'm close to my family and I'm also doing what I enjoy throughout the day. Not like doing a job I don't like or anything like that. Yeah.
Like doing your purpose, but at the same time not forgetting that family, friends, loved ones are like at the forefront.
They're part of the purpose, I guess.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's good, man. So what's the thing that motivates you each day to go to the gym?
Be honest, especially the last couple months, I haven't really been super motivated to go to the gym. I would say it's not about motivation. I've made it a habit in my life to make it to the gym whether I feel like going or not. I have this way of self-talking to myself to get my ass out the door and in the car. Yeah. But what motivates me when I am motivated, it's usually when I have a goal hanging out there, like something specific I'm working towards.
Yeah.
That, you know, time is of the essence type deal. What about you?
Pretty much around the same lines as you at this point in my career, my lifting career. I've been lifting, I think this year is exactly 10 years that I've been lifting. Probably 5 years more seriously, let's just say. Or not seriously, but just smarter. So at this point, I just kind of like just do it. Really, it's kind of what we talked about earlier as well. It's more about the kind of like that discipline or motivation. I just kind of like show up. It's almost as if like I'm just brushing my teeth. Like
yeah.
But to give you some like just a little bit more scope on that, I would say that maybe progress, man. Like just seeing like fucking awesome progress and making sure that I'm not losing what I've worked so fucking hard to build. You know what I mean? In times that I don't feel like it, I'm like, fuck, like, this is an investment for the future. You know what I mean? So, yeah.
I couldn't agree more. Next up, do you just guns blazing. Shout out to Daraja. Ask him these first two questions, actually. Do you guys want kids? I'm going to let you take that one first, bro. Gladly.
Man, I was immediately going to say yes. And I feel like I'm in a stage of life where right now I don't see myself having kids anytime soon. Just because there are certain things in my life that I'd like to accomplish before I decide to settle down and build a family. But I think eventually it would be an honor to, you know, bring another life into this world, because, you know, my mother did it for me. And not only that, I think, not to get too deep and personal, even if you guys want personal, you get personal. But my father was never in the picture for me as a kid. So I've always had this idea that, man, I want to be exactly what he wasn't for me, and I want to be able to be the best that possible. So I think that in the future, I think that's going to be a part of my big why of the things, of why I do the things I do.
It's powerful, man. I think these are intense, bro.
These are intense.
And thank you for sharing that. I don't have, I'm fortunate to have had my father in the picture. Mm-hmm. I do want kids, 100%. If you asked me a couple years ago, I definitely would have been less sure, but now being 28, I just have noticed the amount we grow in life, and it's almost like we live several lifetimes in a lifetime, and we can't even fathom or predict the person that we're going to be, you know, a year from now, 2 years from now. So I could never say that, you know, when I'm 30, I'm not dying to have kids, because I don't know. I think, you know, at a certain point, especially when you hit some level footing in life, let's say, where you're secure with your finances, who you are as a person, you know, and you're going about your day, I think I will get bored, honestly. Like, I'm ready for a child. I'm ready for someone to share this with. Beyond just a girlfriend or a wife, you know? And I really think that a lot of happiness does come. Like, happiness in my life comes when I see the results of me pouring into other people. And I feel like having kids will be that on, like, a level 1,000, you know?
On a different scale.
Yeah, so this is what I think intellectually, but emotionally, I can only guess.
Oh man. Okay, I guess what's your philosophy for life? Another.
Are we gonna put these? Wow.
Damn. These are heavy hitters, man.
This is me first.
Yeah, this is you.
Whew! Philosophy for life. I'll keep it simple. Why not? I think some people ask why. Why do things? Why get up in the morning? And I just think, why not? Why not do it? Why not chase your dreams? You got one life. We're all going to die. Yeah. We're all going to have a little tombstone unless we get cremated. Yeah. It has a little date born, date died. Why not make the most of it? Why not? Why not go for it while you can? Mm.
Yeah, that's good, man. That's very simple, but very powerful if you really think about it. Shit, man. As far as we know, time's only moving forward. And the more time we have behind us, the less time we have in front of us. And along those lines, we're only decaying. So, man, it's almost as if kind of like what you're tying into, like, why not chase your dreams? Why not do the things that you know make you excited and allow you to find an extreme level of joy? Because, man, we're not going to be able to take any of this, you know, any of all these materialistic things with us to our deathbed, man. You know what I mean? So it's just like my philosophy for life is just honestly to just kind of tie it all in together and keep it. Bring it back to being simple before I get too deep, is to just just fucking be a good human being, dude. Honestly, like, be a fucking good human being. Learn how to love. Learn how to be compassionate and empathetic. Yeah, man, I ideally would, you know, want people to speak good things about me when I'm no longer in this world.
Drop the mic, bro. Alright, I think this is, alright, we're getting some, like, not so heavy hitters. Why do you think wearing a back belt during a workout is bad? Okay, that one was one asked me directly, so I can take that quickly. I don't think wearing a belt is bad. I've never said wearing a belt is bad. I personally choose to not wear a belt when I lift because I don't like it. That's the answer. So, you know, please don't read into that. I don't like when I'm lifting with a belt. I don't like the way it makes me feel. I like the feeling when I'm not having it on. And that's like literally as far as my logic goes with it. So, George, on the other hand, you wear belts.
Yeah. I guess it's very context dependent, man. When we're talking about specificity, what are you training for specifically? How can you use it to your advantage? And again, it's just preference. For me, I primarily train for powerlifting. Using a belt at powerlifting meets is not absolutely necessary. However, you could use it to your advantage extremely to be able to create intra-abdominal pressure. And it makes a significant difference when it comes to, you know, the stability of the particular movement and the force that you're able to generate because of the vast stability. So I guess it's just very context dependent. Again, things are never black and white, right? It's just sort of in the middle. So,
thanks.
Absolutely hate doing abs, but if you could recommend just three exercises, what would they be?
Ab exercises?
Yeah.
I love rope cable pull downs, crunches, rope cable crunches. I love doing scissors, laying flat on the ground. Maybe I can find some layover video. And then just like hanging leg raises, bro. What about you?
Same.
Cable cool.
Crunches. Just do, you know, some kind of crunch and some kind of, you know, leg raises or something along those lines.
Yeah.
Lower, yeah. Upper abs.
And I will say, like, George and I were laughing about how not often we train abs.
Yeah.
We literally, like, it's honestly, can't speak, laughable. But like, the messages we get about training abs and how to get abs. Guys, you don't get abs by doing ab exercises. You do it by training the right way, compound lifts, eating healthy, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Is gaining weight harder than losing?
Man, that's gonna be extremely individual based, man. There's a lot of people who can easily put on weight and they struggle extremely hard with fat loss and vice versa.
Yeah, I agree. It's interesting, I find this, there's, having clients online, having worked with so many people, I find when an individual holds a belief that it's hard to gain weight, they also eerily find it hard to eat during the day and they just can never get the calories in. However, the person who thinks it's hard to lose fat, they are almost always hungry and they can't seem to curb their craving. So I think it really comes down to a belief thing. Obviously it is physiological too. I'm not denying biology or anything like that, but I think there's a lot of perception involved in it too. When people identify as a hard gainer, as an ectomorph, as someone who can't gain weight, they're looking for reasons why it should be hard to gain weight. And they run into all these roadblocks because it's what they're seeing. So I think for anyone who identifies with it's hard to lose fat, how about you, you know, start sitting with the belief of it's easy to lose fat. And, you know, it's going to feel like you're lying to yourself for the first month, 2 months. But if you shift that belief over time, I think you'll find it easier. That's a very philosophical answer, but I think it's true.
Within kind of a similar topic, tips on how to consume more calories.
No. I'll keep it quick. I'd say eat for a wider range of time during the day. So, you know, when you wake up to when you go to bed, split up more meals, 5 to 6 meals or even 7 meals throughout the day. And don't be afraid of calorically dense, quote unquote, unhealthy foods like, you know, candies and chips and stuff like that. You know, if you're finding it hard to get calories in, you need to eat foods like that, because you can't eat chicken, tilapia, rice, and freaking, you know, can't expect to get all those calories in.
Well, I totally agree, man. I mean, you could even go the route of a meal replacement if you wish to, especially for conveniency purposes for those individuals who are extremely busy. But just like Brian touched up on, I would say going for foods that are that don't have a lot of volume, but they have a lot of bang for their buck when it comes to their calories. So something like chocolate-covered almonds, man, you could probably eat like five almonds, and that's probably like 200 and something calories, and that's not going to fill you up. So yeah, you could go that approach.
Favorite food, go.
Woo! Favorite food. Holy cow.
I know, man. I freaking hate questions like this. So hard.
Favorite food. So let's just say, hypothetically speaking, I was the last person on this world, and I had to choose only one food to eat for the rest of my life. Could it be a meal, or just like, what's food? Like, it's just one thing that...
I think favorite food refers to like, it could be like quesadillas, or like a dish, you know? Mm-hmm. Okay. I would say.
Okay. I would say...
We'll open it up. It could be a meal.
Honestly, I would say a fucking Chipotle bowl.
Chipotle bowl.
Like, just white rice and steak. That's it. Like, that's my favorite meal, man. Honestly. Like, it's not even... Like, a survival standpoint, like, I eat that shit so much, man.
Yeah.
And I honestly, like, there's something about white rice, bro. Like, jasmine, basmati, like.
That's a good point. Like, you could definitely go the route. Like, I could go saying, like, I eat, like, eating fucking, like, brownie batter. Yeah. And that is very true. But when I hear favorite food, too, it's, like, probably something you have frequently.
Yeah, that's what I'm
saying. So I would, honestly, dude, I think I would actually say the same. In terms of frequency and just enjoyability, steak, white rice, basmati rice, jasmine rice, good to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the best advice you've ever received?
Woo! I always come back to, I'm surprised I thought of this fast, but it's actually very true. I must have read it somewhere, I don't know where I heard it, I don't know if someone told it to me directly, but people think about you much less than you think that they do. Mm-hmm. To someone who is self-conscious, which I think every human being is self-conscious to a certain degree, I kind of take solace in the idea of like, yo, like, people are selfish inherently. They're thinking of themselves and their problems out there right now. No one's fucking thinking about you. And I'm not saying that to be like a cynic, but just... To me, that's freeing. It's like, do what you want. Mm. Do what you want with your life. People don't care. Like, someone may make a bad comment on social media or whatever, but that motherfucker's not thinking about that comment he made 5 minutes later. He's got his own freaking, like, hell of a life that he's created for himself. Like, do what you want.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. What people think of you is none of your business kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
I got this one. Oh, wait, you're going to go in? Well, you didn't answer. Was that your answer to the question?
Oh, no.
Oh, wasn't? Oh, my bad.
No, I disagree with you as well. But, I mean, the best advice I've ever received, and it kind of, I would say almost, I don't recall where I might have gained, you know, somebody, if somebody said this to me, or I got it from a book, or I don't know. But it's a mantra that I say to myself quite often, actually, and it's simple. If not me, then who? And that simple mantra to me is extremely powerful, because, you know, there's no magical time in this universe where somebody's going to come knocking at your door. It's going to be like, here's a successful business. Here's, you know, the wife of your dreams. Here's, you know, the accolades of being a good human being. We have to actively and consciously choose that for ourselves, because nobody else is going to do that for us. So if not me, then who? Mm-hmm.
I like it, man. Best supplement. Let's keep these like super quick. Best supplements, top three. No BS, please. Okay.
Caffeine. Creatine monohydrate. Caffeine, creatine monohydrate, man, and I would honestly fucking say fish oils. A good omega-3s.
I would say...
What?
I would say definitely caffeine. I wasn't going to say caffeine because I sometimes it slips in my mind as it technically is a supplement, but yeah. Caffeine, creatine, and probably branched-chain amino acids, BCAAs. I noticed a big difference in terms of energy during the day, performance, consistent energy. I love the taste of them. I love that it keeps you satisfied. I don't know.
Cool. Where are you from?
I grew up until like almost high school outside of Boston. Then I moved to West Virginia, which is like outside of Washington, D.C.
I am born and raised in Puerto Rico. Moved at the age of 12 to Boston, lived there for 8 years, and then moved to Florida, and I've been there for 8 years. So,
yo, I always forget you're from, you lived in New England. That's so weird, bro. How strict is your diet?
Shit, man. As strict as that I fucking pretty much eat anything I want, actually. It's not strict at all. I haven't dieted meticulously for over 4 or 5 years since that was the last time that I competed in bodybuilding. Since I've been doing powerlifting, for the most part, I've been more or so intuitively eating. I am mindful in the sense of making sure that I am getting enough protein, just because I don't want to lose the muscle that I have, and I also want to build muscle, right? So it's just like, if I'm not supplying that, then I'm almost shooting myself in the foot. But it's not strict at all. If I want something, I have no problem with having it, you know? But that's something that I feel like I've, man, that's something, this is going to sound like kind of like a entitled asshole, but I feel like I've earned it. And what I mean by that is that my consistency over the last 10 years has been like fucking 9 out of 10, you know, with just my training, building muscle. So now I can get away with being a lot more lenient, opposed to somebody who's probably potentially just starting off and it's overweight and can't necessarily afford to be that lenient. They need to be more strict. You
know? Yeah. Mine's not very, I'm not tracking right now. Track sometimes during the week. During prep, I track, so.
You have any book recommendations?
Book recommendations. I'm just gonna do one. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey.
I would say how to influence friends and win people over, is it?
How to Win Friends and Influence People?
By Dale Carnegie.
How to Make Weak Arms Bigger with Veins.
Make weak arms bigger. Well, you fucking get a BFR strap, right? And then you wrap it around your arm. You just start chugging. I'm talking about like sea salt. Like, just start cracking it in your mouth and drink
a little bit of water. I was like, I hope this motherfucker is not talking about BFR bands for real right now.
And just get a nasty pump, bro. I mean, good lighting, get a little bit of tanning on, like, yeah.
Start jerking that shit.
Bro, what are you talking about, man? Bro, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
Make weak arms bigger. We were just talking about this yesterday. You can train smaller body parts more frequently. You can hit your arms almost every single day.
You should.
Yeah. You can hit arms every single day if they're not as big as you want them to be. Veins, this is something that's highly genetic. Veins will come out more when you reduce your body fat percentage, which will only happen when you eat in a caloric deficit. Yeah. So.
You have any beef? Bloomberg. Cut. Now. You have any beef with a fitness influencer?
Yes, I do. For sure. I'm not going to name names, though.
But why? Not names, but why, maybe.
So, it's someone with a big YouTube channel. His name starts with an O. And he posted a YouTube video basically hating on a product that
myself and some friends created, that you are a part of, fun fact, last year. And it really hurt me because we poured a lot of time and effort into that product and it helped a lot of people. So I saw him at my gym here in LA. This has got to be like 3-4 months ago when he was visiting a girl that he dates in LA. He's a like a, basically like a gym shark butt girl. And I confronted him in the gym about it and he like got very like uptight and was like really talking about how it was not marketed the right way. And this guy basically just, and I'm not someone who ever creates controversy, like very rarely ever, but for someone to like post a YouTube video specifically on something I worked hard on, it just kind of like grinds my gears. It grinds my gears. We'll just say that much. So yeah, that's great. Not everyone's gonna like you though, or like what you do, and that's fine. And the best part about it is the next day, Gymshark butt girl that dated him, when I was talking to him at the gym, she like observed the situation, which I was cordial about it, but I asked him why, and it was kind of like out of the blue. She unfollowed me on IG, so I lost that follow because I guess I stand up for myself. I'm not worthy. I've never been worthy of the Gymshark crew, I guess. I don't know. That was the fakest fucking laugh in the world. That was like the most...
Yo, they're never slapping me like that again, alright?
Excuse me?
Anywho, honestly, I don't have any beef, man.
Dude, you get along with fucking everybody. This dude, low-key... This dude is, like, the most connected dude. Like, you'll be looking at other people's IGs on fitness, like, in certain cities, and then you'll just see in the back, like George is with his beard in the back. Oh yeah, George knows them too, he's there. You're connected as fuck, bro, and everyone loves you. That's a good thing. You know, I'm kind of poking fun, but it's awesome.
I appreciate that, man. Yeah, I've just never, you know, I don't know, man. It's just fucking wasted energy, man, honestly.
Shout out to Christian.
How to
get lean and build muscle at the same time.
I keep saying this over and over again, but this is going to be very contextual. Based on, you know, physiology, how serious you are with training, with your nutrition. But if I were to give advice, I would say be as consistent as possible with your training. Always make sure that you're incorporating some form of progressive overload, and you don't necessarily have to be eating in an aggressive caloric surplus. But I would say even potentially just a slight surplus if we're talking about building muscle, right? Because honestly, the only way to put on muscle is through stimulus and progressive overload in a combination of eating enough calories.
So I would say I agree with George. Basically, train really hard. Train really hard. We want the calories you consume throughout the day to fuel your body, like the absolute necessary bodily processes, and then let's fuel that muscle rebuilding. And you don't have to eat a super clean diet, but if you could cut down on like the eating out kind of junk foods, that'll help you out a bunch.
How often should you be changing your macros?
I used to think you had to change your macros quite frequently, like once a week or so. But then when I went through my conscious prep with Paul, on my prep, I think after all said and done, we went 16 weeks. My macros changed one time. Besides peak week, obviously, but they changed one time.
Wow.
In 16 weeks, 4 months. Yeah. So people think I did something a little different this week. What should my macros be now? Mm-hmm. It's be consistent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, again, it's going to be, I keep saying this, but it is. It's always so dependent on what your goals are. If your goal is to lose body fat and you honestly can say that you are tracking very meticulously and you're not losing any weight, then yeah, change your macros. But if you're making progress, if you're losing 1 to 2 pounds per week, keep the calories the same. And even give yourself some buffer time sometimes. If you don't lose weight 1 week, just give it another week. Just kind of for your body to recalibrate and potentially lose weight, so.
Cool. I'm gonna ask you two questions because they're so quick.
How old are you? Why the long beard?
27, because why not?
I love it. 28, not applicable. If I try to grow that out, it looks like pubic hair.
Yeah. In periods of stagnancy in your life, what helped you snap out of it? Ooh. To help, essentially, he said, to help you move forward?
Dude, I love that. That's a great question. Because I just actually kind of like got out of that phase. I was like around the winter time, I think a couple videos ago, if you guys may have tuned in, I was speaking on it, but I think it's somewhat natural for us to have kind of like high and low periods in life. And I think I can tie a lot back to when I started to dip into lows and wasn't sure why. It's because I got away from specific practices that were keeping me at the top of my game. And guys, I'm talking about small stuff, not like monumental. I'm talking about like getting up at a certain time, brushing your teeth, showering, putting on clothes, bonus points if you picked them out the night before. Like, these are things that are like, most are gonna be like, duh, like what else? But ask yourself the question, are you doing these basic things or are you not? I think I wasn't, during times when I'm kind of feeling in a lull or in a low, I'm not sticking to my basics. I'm not getting up at a reasonable time with a few priorities that I'd like to get done for the day. I'm not intentional with my training. Like, there's no end goal in mind. And like, when you're off your game and you start compromising yourself, all of these little compromises throughout the day, I think they add up. And it creates unease, and then you start getting frustrated with the lack of results that you're creating compared to this other time in your life when you were doing better, quote unquote. And then it can really just send you down in a hole if you don't really recognize the small stuff that you've stopped doing. Long answer, but yeah, it's my answer.
That's a good answer, man. Good answer.
George, I love when you think, bro. It's like, he's about to say some fire shit right now. You're like, you like lock in. You're like, brain is working.
Power thoughts.
Power thoughts.
Oh man.
Fuck. Bro, we got.
That's an inside joke.
What's the channel? Cody KO.
Cody KO.
Yo, go to Cody KO's channel. Should we tell them what we did last night? Oh, this sounds so gay.
This is gonna sound so bad.
I mean, I'm not homophobic. My best friend's gay. We laid in bed until 3 a.m. last night watching Cody KO's YouTube channel, dying laughing. So
all the way till 3 a.m. bro.
Yeah, please don't click off the video, please show us some love. But after this, if you're on a binge and avoiding work or stuff, shame on you, don't do that, but keep it going a little bit longer and watch Cody KO's channel.
Absolutely. Periods of stagnation, man. I feel like, if I'm being quite honest, man, this is you know, kind of what Brian said, it's, you know, ebbs and flows. There's times in your life where you feel stagnant, other times where when you feel like you're, everything is just moving in the right direction. I just went through this extremely recently, and something that helped me snap out of it, if I'm going to give practical advice, was to essentially really take inventory of what were the things that I was doing.
Hi.
Yeah, you too.
Are you pausing the thought?
No, I'm pausing.
Oh, we're.
You guys want a piece of pizza?
What were the things that I was doing on not only my day-to-day basis, but even moment-to-moment basis, whether that was, you know, certain practices or my morning routine schedule, when things were going absolutely fantastic versus now that I feel stagnant in life. And man, it's almost as if you have that feedback, you have that evidence, that data, and we can only connect the dots from moving backwards. So it's just like, I think for me, even as of now, it was honestly just going back to doing a lot of those habits that I know allow me to essentially be my best self. Things that I know that make me feel good, whether that's waking up on time, you know, making sure that I am keeping my word with a commitment,
you know, things like that, and you start to rebuild, you know, confidence and essentially build momentum. So long story short, just take inventory of some of the habits that you're currently undergoing and make and check yourself. Are these aligned with whom I want to be or where I want to be in life? And if not, well, you have to change some shit. And if yes, we'll continue to do it and just fucking understand that.
Bro, your answers are so fucking long.
Okay.
I'm sorry. That's it, bro.
I can, bro, good, answers it's like good. This, I it's, can't.
It's good shit, but fuck, man. This is going to be so long.
Let me just do it again real quick, actually. So we can just take that. Yeah. Honestly, I'm known for really giving long answers for questions like this. So to keep it simple, one of the things that I did recently to break out of this stagnation in my life was just take inventory of my current habits. And essentially, what were the habits that I was doing then when I was feeling at my best? And I essentially replaced them with the habits that I know are going to allow me to be my best self and move in the direction that I'm wanting to move in life.
I love it. How do you stay so lean? Okay, we took it there. Let's go.
Cardio, baby. Shit, but no, really.
But actually, this dude, it's good. Where? It's YouTube. All right. Sorry.
No. Go ahead.
You didn't ask the fucking question. Oh, you wait. That okay? That's your answer. All right. How do you stay so lean? All right. So, damn, bro.
I kind of threw you off.
How do I answer that? I'm like, you in a caloric deficit. You know, like get a big bump.
Give me your answer, man.
How do you stay so lean? Just train hard and eat well. Mm-hmm. I know that's, you guys are literally fucking nauseous with that answer, but it's literally the truth. Mm-hmm. I think it's your turn.
Just don't eat like an asshole.
Don't
eat like an asshole. Yeah. Just fucking train hard.
And also, on a real note, don't fucking lie to yourselves. I know because I've been there. Like, I can see it so obviously when I've been there before. Mm-hmm. So many fucking people, like, that watch YouTube and shit, like, you fucking lie to yourself about like, oh, I'm so on my grind and shit. Motherfucker, you know you're not committed on Friday and Saturday. Fuck out of here.
Man.
It's just the truth. You're not fucking committed. Stop acting like you are.
Nobody's
you're eating like
I'm
a fucking douche. You're drinking
pizzas.
So fucking much. I know it. I've been there. You've been there.
100%, man.
Like, there comes a point where it's like, my commitment level is not creating the fucking results I want. And it's honestly fucking embarrassing right now to me. And when you hit it, your back's against the wall, you decide to make a change. But until then, you still live in this delusion to make yourself feel better during the week that I'm so on my grind and I need to ask an influencer a question again about how to get lean because I fucking asked the same thing last week, but I fucked it all up this weekend and then you're in this fucking cycle. Mm-hmm. Stop doing that. You have enough information.
And stop being an asshole. What I mean by that is stop asking questions and we're giving you legitimate answers. I like to consider myself an individual who's, you know, rather knowledgeable in certain areas of life. When it comes to fitness, I've done my due diligence. And if I, you know, give you advice, man, I mean, fuck, go out there and put it into practical application. Don't just fucking, oh, okay, and then that's it.
Facts, B. Jay, I'm B.
Okay. 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 Okay.
It's your question.
How long did it take you to physically get where you are?
Physically get where I am?
How long did it take you to get where you are physically?
Well, I've been training the same amount of time as you, man. That's crazy. 10 years. Wow. So you're 27? Well, actually, I'm 11. I'm 11 years then because I started training at 17. I'm 28. Mm-hmm. So I would say 11 years. I was an athlete before I started working out, so that counts as work, I guess. Mm-hmm. You know, that definitely counts as work, but like specific weight training, growing the muscles, 11 years.
Yeah, me, I would have to say probably 27 years, considering that my mom had me when I was like, when she was 19.
I can't tell if you're kidding. Are you joking?
I came out the womb, then I moved to...
this fucking guy to a beer for 2 hours.
No, that was just a fucking joke of an answer. But really, I mean, it's taken me 10 years. I mean, what else? Exactly right here, right now, it's taken me 11 years to get where I am. Are you rough in bed?
Wait.
Are you rough in bed?
Here it comes, man.
To burn extra calories.
To burn extra calories. All right. Let's be, like, straight up. You are literally fucking Ted Bundy status if you are rough in bed to burn more fucking calories. Am I right? You're a psychopath. Who thinks in bed that I want to burn extra calories so I'm going to be rough? No. That's not, like, do people think that way? You're being too quiet for me. I'm, like, now I'm scared. No, I don't, I'm not rough in bed to burn extra calories. I'm not usually a rough in bed dude. That being said, I'm a fucking man. I have a wiener. Things happen. I like being in bed with girls. And if she asks to be rough, because some girls like that shit. They're like, choke me. Mm. Some girls will fucking ask that. I don't sleep around a lot, but like it has happened one time. And I was very uncomfortable, but that's when I would be rough. What's your answer?
I think there's a spectrum when it comes to roughness.
Power thought!
This person said it in a jokingly manner. She's put emoji in there and laughing, like winkies, that, you know what I mean? Like crying face. Man, I would honestly, just to keep it simple, I would say that that is my preferred choice of cardio. That's not to say that I'm a man slut. What I'm saying is that when I'm with a particular individual, I like to have a lot of sex with them. I think it's a beautiful thing. I think it's a work of art. I think it's the closest way that you could potentially get intimate with another human being. I mean, that's enough. Jesus God,
man. All right, well, we're just going to continue on this fucking bender we got going. What kind of chicks you into? George, let him know.
I'm into them. Big booty girls. Preach for the
glory. Real talk though. I know this sounds crazy. Well, not sounds crazy. I would say I can sit here and like we already know we're all into like somebody who's respectful and has independence and yes, those all of those things are true. But I also have to be physically attracted to you. I know a lot of people say physical attraction. You know what I'm saying? Doesn't matter. I say that's fucking bullshit.
Bro, a dude asked this question. He wants to know, like, are you an ass man or a boob man, essentially?
I'm a fucking ass man. I could care less if you have boobs. You can have a fucking
cocky. Yeah, he doesn't want to know if you like empathy.
That's what I'm saying. It's
I like fucking amazing asses. I don't give a shit about boobs. They can literally have concave fucking boobs and a six face if it's a perfect ass. Yeah. Maybe not six face, but seven. But yeah, I could go to ungodly compensations for an amazing ass, and I've just accepted that. That is my truth. I'm just being honest.
Same.
I could front and be like, oh yeah, well rounded.
Bro, what's crazy about that is that we're like, there's, man, this is gonna make me sound like a horny ass bastard, man. Like
you are, bro. You are. He.
No, I'm not, man. I just,
own your truth, bro. This dude,
I just have an appreciation for.
He looks at his phone all day. It's always women. I said it.
Making me sound like a creep.
bro, you gotta reckon with it sometime.
Man, I just have an appreciation, I guess, for a good fucking attractive woman with a nice dumper.
I think it's your. I think. How did you guys meet?
Grindr.
Grindr?
You know what Grindr is?
Yeah, I know what Grindr is, bro.
we met through a friend of mine. Austin, right? No, we met through Amanda, bro.
Oh, shit. That's right. Toronto.
Yeah, we met through a friend of
mine. I thought he was trying to hook up with my girlfriend.
Funny story. That is a funny story. So... Actually, the way we met was
a little jealous fucking prick, Brian.
I've been cool with Amanda Bucci for quite some time now. or for quite a while, even before Brian was in the picture. And then Brian kind of came into the picture, and she was in at the Toronto Pro, right? The Toronto Pro Expo. So I had hit her up, and I was like, yo, like, let's fucking hang out, blah, blah, blah. And she was like, yeah, like, it's cool. Like, I'm with my boyfriend, all this shit. So I went to a restaurant that they were at. So literally me, Brian, and Amanda all had burgers, and then we went and got ice cream, and we were talking about coaching and shit like that. But I didn't know that Brian literally was an insecure little,
I was a little hoe, man. I was like,
this guy's trying to hook up with my girl and shit. And generally, it wasn't my intention. I know Amanda's for just, you know, some time, and she's just a cool chick, of course. But it's so funny how, like, and then we honestly were, then we got to know each other, and you were like, fuck, like, this dude is fucking great.
I don't think that.
I know, you only think that on days I am with a Y, typically.
Oh, that's a good one, bro. That's a good one.
And that's how we met. Now, fucking 3 years later, you know, we've become extremely good friends and almost brothers, I would say, at this point.
Also don't agree. All right, what's your question?
Yo, that's not funny real talk. What's your basic guidance to someone who's going to start working out, essentially?
Guidance to someone who's going to start working out?
Yeah.
I would say go to the gym and be curious. Yeah, that's it. Go to the gym and be curious. Try the equipment. Like, don't think you have to be super regimented or anything like that. Just, you know, I love the discovery phase of finding out like what equipment did in the gym and stuff. I still feel like I still am, honestly. There's always new equipment and stuff coming out
too.
But just be curious. Try new equipment, learning about training philosophies, look up different body part training splits.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I would say, yeah. It's almost as if fall in love with the process and the journey of it.
Here's one. Did you ever have gym anxiety? I never like heard of that. I may have heard of it, but did you ever have gym anxiety?
I don't know, never. I was cocky as fuck, bro.
That's interesting. I definitely did.
I never did.
You were a basketball and a football player, no? Not football player.
I was a track, yeah, baseball and track star.
Baseball and track. Star. He threw in the star. Damn, my ego just flared up because I was a track star. What'd you run?
Did I say track star?
I was not a fucking track star.
I was not a track star. It was just like, I thought that's what it's called, a track star. Track star means that you're a fucking one.
A track star.
You should do fucking track, bro.
Yeah.
But I was a baseball star, yeah.
You were good at baseball, weren't you?
Yeah.
You're damn.
That was my first passion. Yeah.
The Puerto Rican, like, stereotype, bro.
Yeah, it's just a stereotype.
Yes, I did experience gym anxiety. I was a skinny kid, soccer player, runner, cross country. So it's like it was just new territory, this whole building. We'll just knock out some quick ones. Favorite TV show?
Oh, shoot, man. It's between Dexter and Breaking Bad. I can't decide, man. Breaking Bad, probably.
Breaking Bad. I'm not a big TV watcher. I don't even have a Netflix subscription, but when I did, I watched The Patriot Act with Hasan Minhaj. Yo, it's like the best way to get the news informed. It's not like super current. It is actually current, but he's just like a comedian that talks about important issues with like no filter, and he's just hilarious. So, have you ever seen The Patriot Act?
No.
You gotta watch it, dude. You'd love it. What's your height and weight currently?
I'm currently 6'7", 250 pounds, 6% body fat.
Yikes.
Nah, I'm fucking with you guys. 5'7" on days, 5'7" days that I squat, 5'8" on days that I don't squat, and I usually weigh around 205.
Bro, you've always got to give complicated answers to simple questions, I swear to fucking God. How often do you train to failure?
Well, let's see here. Technically speaking, according to calculation of limitation, bless us.
How often do you train to failure?
I fucking don't, man.
I don't.
Okay.
At all.
I trained a failure all the day.
When I used to do AMRAPs, but now everything's so strategically fucking calculated because each session's affect the next week and the next session. So for powerlifting, you know, it's just a little more complicated.
Facts. Powerlifter, well, you are a natural bodybuilder as well. You've won overalls, but now, as of the last, you know, 3, 4, 5 years, right, you've been all powerlifter, programming oriented to a T, really important. When you get into the bodybuilding space, it's the lines are a little more gray.
Yeah.
And you can open up the art, so to speak, more so, I think, whether you train to failure or not. Personally, I choose to train to failure pretty much every day, so. This is just simple, I guess. How to manage exercise plan during exam time. I'm having tough time in my third year. So just like when you're busy, I guess.
Well, so something that I do, because I do coach some collegiate level powerlifters, and during exam times, what we'll do is we'll usually, you know, I'll have them tell me ahead of time. That way I can program a deload or a let's just say a taper during that week, so that way they can just go in there, do, you know, the minimum requirement, and yeah, that's kind of what I do when it comes to the powerlifting side of things.
Cool. So yeah, so mine's, I guess I'll just say, I think life moves in seasons. I'm not going to get super philosophical, but there's seasons, there's times to prioritize different things, like a certain week, it may be exam time. Okay, you've got to prioritize your exams. That's probably the most important thing at that point. It's time to cut back on the training a little bit. If you normally do 5 to 6 days a week, jump it down, only do 2 sessions or 3 sessions. Or even if you can't train at all, don't train at all. It's what you do the majority of the time, I find, that creates the results. So I would say just be realistic here. Cut down on your training. Cut down on it for a week or 2 weeks. And then just go hard in 3-4 weeks. What inspires you? Last question.
Growth, man. Continuous growth.
Growth. I like that. I like that simplicity. For me, it's seeing other people win. Because when I see other people win, it's a reminder that I can win too, George. But on a real note, that is the truth. When I see other people taking on their demons and like pushing forward and leading their life with purpose, that is super fucking inspiring to me. And it doesn't have to be a successful person or a rich person or any like person with a lot of attention. It can be anybody. To see someone like really doing shit that they don't want to do, but I knew they like overcame some shit to do it, I'm like, yo, that's fucking awesome. I want to do that too.
Alchemists, essentially meaning people that turn lead into gold.
Yeah, I love that. All right, guys. That being said, this was a super good Q&A. Hopefully, I pray that we're not going to be over like 40 freaking minutes, but there was some gold in here. I've got to pee so fucking bad. I hope you found some... found some value and also just some humor. Find George's channel right here. George, what you got?
Thank you guys for submitting your questions. Honestly, just some absolutely fantastic questions that we could just really dig into, but we try to keep it as simple as possible, and hopefully you were able to find some piece of advice that was helpful for you in this season of life that you're currently in. So if it did, make sure that you like the video, make sure that you comment what that was, if we touched on anything that might have inspired you, or any moment that you found funny, right?
Yeah, facts.
And obviously,
like George's glasses. Like the video for George's glasses.
Man, like subscribe and shit. We out?
We out.
Let's just walk out of the frame, bro. This is like...
just fucking no high five and shit.
Hold on. I need to do this.